Good day, everybody. Joel here with your tropical update. Of course, today is Thursday, September the 10th, 2020. And boy, oh boy, look at this. Six different systems. Can you believe that this morning, what we're waking up to? Well, we'll start with disturbance number one up here, where we've been following. Not going to turn into a storm or anything, but boy, oh boy, let me tell you what. The rain has been coming down at my house in buckets. Now, it's a trough of low pressure. It's located just off the coast of North Carolina. It is producing minimal shower and thunderstorm activity, and at my house is a lot right now. Now, this system is expected to move inland over eastern North Carolina this afternoon, and therefore significant development, of course, is not expected. It's just going to be a big old rainmaker, folks. So even along, I'd say, as far as Myrtle Beach, maybe a little bit south of Myrtle Beach, right on up my coastline, we are going to get the rain and a little gust now and then, but no big deal with the wind. But the rain is going to happen. Look what's going on now. My goodness, this is disturbance number one. Well, now we have disturbance number two. Number two, right here. It's disorganized showers, thunderstorms. It's centered a couple of hundred miles northeast of the central Bahamas, and it is associated with a surface trough of low pressure. Now, it's looking like this system is forecast to move westward, crossing the Bahamas and Florida Friday, tomorrow, and then move into the eastern Gulf of Mexico over the weekend. Now, upper-level winds are expected to become conducive for some development of this system while it moves slowly west-northwestward over the eastern Gulf of Mexico early into next week. And it's zero chance for the next 2 days. It's a 30% chance over the next 5 days. We will keep our eyes on this, so I'd say everyone right in this area, say south of Lake Okeechobee, on down south, you guys are going to get some rain. Might be a little further north, but I think it's looking more this way. And then, my goodness gracious, we got another one. Disturbance number three. This has just popped up this morning. It's another trough of low pressure, and it has developed over the northeastern Gulf of Mexico and is producing a few disorganized showers and thunderstorms. Now, some slow development of this system is possible while this system moves westward and then southwestward over the northern and western Gulf of Mexico through early next week. Now, the chance is low, folks. Try not to panic, okay? It's low. Should be a big rainmaker. However, who knows? It's in the Gulf. We're going to have to watch it. But it's got a 10% chance in 2 days and a 20% chance in 5 days. And if this one does cross over and get in the Gulf, who knows? We may have something trying to go up in this area, but I'm thinking, hopefully, there's a pressure system up here that will make these come down this way. We'll have to wait and see. It's too early to tell. Then, over here, this is a tropical wave now, and it is moving off the west coast of Africa, producing a large area of showers and thunderstorms. Now, development of this system is forecast, and a tropical depression is expected to form by this weekend or early next week. This system should move generally westward across the eastern and central tropical Atlantic. 2 days, 60%, 5 days, 90% chance of developing. Then we have Tropical Storm Paulette. The winds are 60 miles per hour, the pressure 996 millibars, moving west-northwest at 10 miles per hour. And then we have Tropical Storm Rene. Rene's winds are 40 miles per hour, the pressure is 1,003 millibars, it's moving west-northwest at 10 miles per hour. Taking a quick look at the satellite data this morning, we can see here is the system up here bringing us rain. No big deal, just a big rainmaker, and the rain's going all the way up into parts of Delaware, possibly New Jersey. Rain all the way down here. So here's this little system. Off the Bahamas, it's going to go across Florida tomorrow. It's just a rainmaker, folks, just a rainmaker. Don't get upset, but you might have a little gusty wind now and then, but for the most part, it's just going to be a rainmaker and slip on over. And we can see right in here, as this moves along, you can see right here where this little system in the Gulf has tried to stir up already, right in here. No big deal right now. We're going to keep our eyes on it, okay? I think it should come up maybe, or try to come up maybe this way. But as you can see, we have this system that's pushing on through across. As you can tell, I think it may bring it on down this way. We're going to watch all of this area. Do not fret. Do not worry. Along with everything else going on. Now, first, let's get to this system. As you can see right here, coming off of Africa, it is disorganized this morning. You can see it's disorganized. It should develop over the next few days. But you know what? We've got another one that's going to come off the coast of Africa. I want to switch over to the satellite that shows Africa more this morning. Here's Paulette. Here's Rene. Here's the system that's off the coast now that's disorganized. But would you look here? This looks like a big fat system that can start up for sure, don't it, folks? It's another tropical wave. It's looking like it's going to merge off the coast of Africa this weekend. And it's looking like the conditions could be conducive for some slow development over the Atlantic. Now, right now it's still here in Africa. It's got to have a few days to get off this weekend. Looking like it could have some slow development when it gets off also, so we got to keep our eyes on it. As we come back to the wide view of the Atlantic with the satellite data, here's Paulette, right? Well, what is going on with Paulette? It's looking like Paulette's center of circulation is just separated, okay, farther south from the cloud mass, and this has happened during the past couple of hours, and you can see right in here how it's separating. Well, it's looking like now that the European model and the FV3 ship's intensity model show that shear magnitude is increasing. And as a result, Paulette is expected to begin weakening by this evening. Now, over the weekend, the shear is forecast to decrease gradually and shift from the southwest and become a bit more defluent. Now, this should allow for re-intensification. Now, several of the intensity guidance models included the ships and the consensus models. HCCA and IVCN are now showing Paulette as a hurricane in 4 days or sooner. 4 days or sooner. Now, by Saturday morning, a break in a ridge that's going to develop due to the combination to mid and upper level winds situated to the northwest of Paulette and the mid-latitude shortwave trough moving off the northeast U.S. coast. This is going to change the synoptic steering pattern. It should cause Paulette to turn toward the northwest with an increase in the forward speed. So Paulette is going to keep moving like she's moving right now, then she's going to try to come up, then she's going to go over, and then she's going to come up again. Now, Paulette should be a hurricane by the time it gets up around Bermuda, and it will get up around Bermuda. This is the latest coordinates from the National Hurricane Center in 120 hours, which is 32.0 north, 64.9 west. And at this time, it's looking like Paulette will have winds of hurricane strength at 85 miles per hour. You can see here is Bermuda. Paulette has not moved to that north-northeasterly pattern yet. She's going to keep going a little bit more to the west and then come up. So it's like everybody who is in Bermuda, if you have anybody visiting on vacation, family, friends, whatever, you need to make them aware of this or you need to call and check on them. Because Bermuda really needs to start to prepare. And for everyone wondering how close this is to the coast of North Carolina, well, from Hatteras to Bermuda is around 659 miles. Bermuda is around 659 miles from Cape Hatteras, North Carolina. Now let's check out right quick Rene, Tropical Storm Rene right here. What's going on with her? Well, it's looking like that much of the microwave overpasses right now are indicating that Rene continues to be affected by easterly shear. It's being affected by easterly shear with the low-level centered just near the eastern edge of the ongoing bursting of convection that Rene is producing. Now, Rene should move generally west-northwestward for the next couple of days, followed by a turn to the northwest into a weakness in a subtropical ridge, partly caused by tropical storm Paulette. Now, this is going to make it more problematic due to uncertainties into how much ridging will build north of Rene, and uncertainties will make it close to a larger Paulette. Will it make it get a little closer or not? This is going to have a lot to do with it. Now, the shear should gradually diminish during the next 4 to 3 days, and this should allow Rene to strengthen to or near hurricane strength. And after that time, strong west-northwesterly shear is expected to cause a gradual weakening, despite that Rene is moving over very warm sea surface temperatures. However, Rene does have that chance to reach a Category 1 hurricane in about 60 hours from now. So we'll watch Rene. She shouldn't be a threat to land at this time. We will wind this up right quickly here with the European model. This little dot right here where the hand is, that's Bermuda. This is Paulette. Here's Rene. You can see there's hardly no wind at all in these systems for 1, 2, and 3 at this time in these areas right here. So this is this evening around 10 p.m. Let's move it up to around 5 p.m. tomorrow afternoon. You can see a little bit of wind gust in here with what is going to be going over Florida. Not bad, 26 miles per hour. It's nothing, folks. I'm just telling you. You're not going to get a lot of wind, but you are going to be getting some rain. Now let's concentrate mostly as we move through time. We will come up to Saturday around 9 p.m. You can see Paulette tries to start to take that little turn up there. Here's Rene. Here's another system. And here's another system. Okay, and the big low hadn't got off yet. So, off of Florida. So we're going to move up to Sunday. And I do want to bring this in right quick and make it a little bigger if I can. So you can see where it says Hamilton. This is Bermuda. Now let's concentrate on Paulette, okay? Paulette, remember, is going to weaken, then she's going to strengthen. Looking like right here by Sunday, she could have 78 mile per hour winds. And this is the location that the National Hurricane Center, that picture with the coordinates, is showing, right below Bermuda. So we will hop up to Monday. I want you to see she doesn't move straight north or northeastward. Paulette moves directly west. Directly west. This is Monday morning. Now for Monday evening around 11 p.m., looking like center circulation. And of course this is going to change. It's going to bounce around, folks. But this is what it's looking like. Just west of Bermuda with 94 mile per hour wind gust, and this is going to be like a Category 1. This is Bermuda, so Bermuda, you need to pay attention. It's going to move all around you, and I just told you it's going to start to intensify, and as it does, these winds are going to increase 101 mile per hour wind gust. And we'll move to Wednesday, and by Wednesday, it is a humdinger. You can't see this. 123 mile per hour wind gust. If all this pans out this way. So that's what's happening with Paulette and where she may go. We'll have to wait and see if all of this pans out. But let's back up in time and get to Tuesday. go back around 3 a.m. Tuesday. We have this. That's Rene. Rene's going to go out and not bother anyone. Now, we have this system right here. Now, it's going to move over the islands, okay? So, let's move up to around 5 p.m. You can see it's moving right along. We'll go to Wednesday. Now, it's picking up a little bit of a strength here. Of course, this can change, but I want to show you guys down on the islands which exact islands may be affected. St. John's, you can see all of these islands right in here. These winds are what? 45 mile per hour wind gusts. We'll move up to 7 p.m. for Wednesday. This is next Wednesday, the 17th. All of you guys can possibly be getting these winds all the way through Puerto Rico. And we'll go to Thursday around 10 a.m. Then the center of this moves down. Now, I have watched this and thought maybe Jamaica might be affected, but I don't think that's what's going to happen. And this is very important to watch. You can see how it's moving along. This is Friday around 3 in the morning. We'll go to Friday the 18th around 8 p.m. Looks like Jamaica's going to escape it, as you can see, and it's going to move back up. The Turks and the Caicos Islands all up here, you're going to get wind. You can see right in here, my goodness gracious, this wind's going to pick up a lot, 68 mile per hour wind. And as we move on down, looking like now it could go, we'll go out Saturday, as far as we can. Looking like it could go right on just south of the Bahama area. You guys will still get stuff, but it's moving on up this way. So Florida, you need to pay attention. You need to pay attention. At this point, looking like winds, 93 mile per hour wind gusts. Once it gets up in this area, it can strengthen some more. It's just got knocked down a little bit because it's going over Cuba and the mountainous areas. So be aware of that. You have to remember that, you know, there's days ahead. All this stuff's going to change. This is just something for you to go by. I'm just showing you something to keep your eyes on and to make you aware. I follow these things every day. And don't worry, just like I'm trying to warn Bermuda right now, I will keep everybody warned. Now, for all the island areas over here, this is the second wave that I'm talking about that hadn't got off of Africa yet. This is Saturday the 19th. It's moving your way. The winds are 96 miles per hour in some areas. In some areas, I think they're even higher, 97. Pretty close, whatever. It is a Category 1, whatever it is right now at this point. I think it is a Cat 1 hurricane. We'll have to wait and see if it develops and what happens to it, because we do have the lows, the highs, the wind, the dry dust. We have all of this stuff, plus much, much more we have to factor into it to see if it actually materializes and does do this. But this is what it's looking like on the European model as of now. If you haven't subscribed and you're into the weather, whether it's tropical weather, forecast, severe weather, any kind of weather that may be of harm to you, please subscribe, click that bell, and check off all to ensure you get all the latest weather videos that I put out to try to keep people aware and keep people safe. Please subscribe. Don't forget to share this information with your family, friends, and on your social media. That helps me out greatly also to keep people aware and to keep people safe. That's it. You can see them all lined up here. Please stay safe. Please stay on these. Please stay on every one of these systems and follow them with me. We don't know what could happen with any of them. The weather is a mess. I'll leave it at that. But I have told you what I have found and what I have seen for today. I love you guys. I thank you for everything you do for me. Have a good day, a safe day, and a blessed day. And may each and every one of you have peace, love, and kindness in your life today. Thanks for watching.